Well, good day, everyone. Meteorologist Marcus Walter here, and I'm coming to you from Naperville, Illinois, a western suburb of Chicago. This area was hit by a powerful tornado last weekend, and it led to a lot of damage and devastation in this area and also areas farther to the east as the storm tracked the ground. And behind me, you see a home that was unfortunately flattened by that tornado as it ripped through this neighborhood. And when you look around this neighborhood, you still see a lot of debris everywhere. Fortunately, the streets have been cleared so cars can drive through the area, but as you see behind me, people are still slowly recovering at this particular home from that powerful tornado that roared through the area. Now, the storm was estimated by the National Weather Service as an EF3 tornado with max winds upwards of 140 miles per hour. And so that lets you know how powerful the winds were. And that wind led to debris being blown in a lot of places around this neighborhood. When you walk around, you still see insulation on the ground. You see broken glass on the ground as well. And you see even pieces of brick, a part of people's homes and chimneys associated with their homes, that are on the ground because of those powerful winds that ripped through the area. And as a meteorologist, when I think about this storm and watching it on radar, it was such a surreal experience to see a tornado showing up on radar and then getting confirmation of it being on the ground as it roared through this neighborhood last weekend. We definitely send our best to the people as they continue to recover from the active weather, but it definitely was something to experience. Unfortunately, nobody wants to experience it, but it was a lot of it was a pretty dramatic situation that people were experiencing in this neighborhood. I spoke with one family who fortunately did not suffer as much damage compared to the home behind me and other homes in the area, and they mentioned that they felt pretty fortunate, but they were also outside cleaning up as well because there's so much debris, so much tree damage, so many limbs still in the area. So again, we send our best to the people in this neighborhood as they continue to recover. Fortunately, today is a beautiful weather day, so they can hopefully enjoy this weather, and it's not too hot as they are outside cleaning up. But it is unfortunately something that they had to deal with, but fortunately now people in this area, they're continuing the recovery process, and I have a feeling that this neighborhood will come back stronger than ever before.